Hello everyone, in this video we will be discussing about module 3, velocity and acceleration analysis of mechanism in graphical methods. So first we will be discussing about the derivation portions of module 3. So what and all we will be discussing under module 3 is velocity and acceleration analysis of forward mechanism, slider crank mechanism and simple mechanism by vector polygons, relative velocity and acceleration of particles in a common link, relative velocity and accelerations of coincident particles on separate links, Coriolis component of acceleration, angular velocity and angular acceleration of links, velocity of rubbing. All these topics we will be discussing in module 3. First we will discuss about relative velocity of two bodies moving in straight lines. Here we shall discuss the applications of vectors for the relative velocity of two bodies moving along parallel lines and inclined lines, which you can able to see in the sketch. So consider two bodies A and B along parallel lines in the same directions. You can able to see, I have considered the two body, this is the A body and this is the B body, which is kept in a parallel lines. You can able to see that with the absolute velocities VA and VB. You can able to see that the body A and body B, set in the parallel line parallel to each other, which has body A have the absolute velocities of VA and body B have absolute velocity of VB, and it is absolute velocity applied is such a way that VA is greater than VB. Even you can able to see that the line of the A is bigger. The relative velocity of A with respect to B is, so how to write out the relative velocity means, for VAB I will be writing, which is equal to vector difference of VA and VB, that is VA bar minus VB bar. So the vector difference of VA and VB is equal to VA bar minus VB bar. So from figure 7.1b, the relative velocity of A with respect to B, that is VAB, may be written in the vector form as follows. Here you can able to see that from the figure 7.b, we can able to see this. I have considered the body A and body B of the absolute velocities VA and VB. So now I will be writing the vector form with respect to this particular point A. I will be writing that. So now I am looking for BA. BA I am looking for. It is nothing but what is the difference between what is the difference when we compare the body B with the body A? So which is denoted as B to A, that is BA. So that I will be writing as BA bar is equal to OA bar minus OB bar. Here we can able to see this. So this can be written as even VAB or VBA. So this is the relative velocity of two bodies moving along parallel lines. Similarly, the relative velocities of B with respect to A can be written as VBA is equal to vector difference of VB, and VA we can able to write that, as we know that the same thing, it is VB bar minus VA bar. So in notations, if you want to write it, means it is AB bar is equal to OB bar minus OA bar. Now consider the body B, which is moving in an inclined direction. You can able to see in the sketch, the relative velocity of A with respect to B may be obtained by the law of parallelogram of velocities or the triangle law of velocities. So we will have a detailed discussion on the parallelogram of velocities diagram. So first, take any fixed point, let me call it as a O, and draw vector to OA. You can able to see the line here, it is OA, this is the OA to represent VA in magnitude and direction to some suitable scale I have taken. Similarly, draw vector OB. Here you can able to see this, here I will be showing OB line to represent VB. This is OB line, so here I am representing VB in magnitude and direction to the same scale. Then vector BA represents the relative velocity of capital A with respect to capital B. which you can able to see in the sketch too. Just see here, very clearly we can able to observe that the vector BA represents the relative velocity of A with respect to B. In the similar way as we discussed now, the relative velocity of A with respect to B also can be calculated. So here I will be writing that as V BA, the vector difference of VB and VA, which is equal to VB bar minus VA bar. So in notations, if you want to write, means it is AB bar, which is equal to OB bar minus OA bar. So now we will discuss about next topic, which is called motion of ring. Let me consider two points A and B on a rigid ring AB, as shown in the first figure. You can able to see, this is here a rigid link of two points A and B. Let one of the extremities, let me consider B point of the link, which move relative to A in the clockwise direction. You can see the arrow mark. This is moving, this B extremity is moving towards A direction in the clockwise direction. Since the distance from A to B remains the same, there cannot be any relative motions between A and B along the line AB. So it is quite obvious that the relative motion of B with respect to A must be perpendicular to AB. Hence, velocity of any point on a link with respect to another point in the same link is always perpendicular to the line joining these points on the configuration, or even we can call it as a space diagram. Now we can discuss the velocity of a point on a link by relative velocity method. The relative velocity method is based upon the relative velocity of the various points of the link. Let me consider two points A and B on a link. On the first sketch, you can able to see that I have considered a link of two points A and B. Even we can call it as the extremities also. Let the absolute velocity of the point A, you can able to see here, this is the point A. Even in vector form, we can call it as the VA, is known in magnitude and direction, and the absolute velocity of the point B, or else VB, is known in direction only. So point A is having a magnitude and direction, and point B, that is VB, which is known only its direction. Then the velocity of B may be determined by drawing a velocity diagram, which is shown in the next sketch. So this is the velocity diagram. Now I will explain how to draw this velocity diagram. Take some convenient point O known as the pole. So here you can able to see, which is as per my convenience, I have taken this point O. Through O, draw a OA parallel. You can able to see this with respect to this pole point. I will be drawing a line OA parallel, which should be equal to the VA to some suitable scale. Since we are discussing only the concepts, here I am not going with any particular scaling. So when we are solving the problems, that time we can decide according to the data given to us. Now through A, draw a line perpendicular to AB of this particular figure, the first figure. So this line actually represents the velocity of B with respect to capital A. Even in a vector form, we can call it as the VBA. Through O, again draw a line parallel to VB, which intersects the line of BBA at B point. You can able to see that exactly it is intersecting at this particular point. Now measure OB, which gives the required velocity of the point B, that is VB to the scale. So here, what are the points we need to remember here, means the vector AB, which represents the velocity of capital B with respect to A, or else we can call it as a BBA, is known as the velocity image of the link AB. And second thing is, the absolute velocity of any point C on AB may be determined by dividing the vector AB at C in the same ratio as C divides AB, which can be very clearly seen in the sketch. So in other words, we can write down as AC by AB. You can able to see that it is AC by AB, which is equal to AC by AB. We can able to see it very clearly. So join OC. See here, I am joining OC. The vector OC represents the absolute velocity of point C, and write AC represents the velocity of C with respect to capital A, that is VCA. Yeah, you can able to see that it is VCA. the angle